Today we will see the Frye's rearrangement reaction and temperature dependency of its products. So first of all, we will see what is Frye's rearrangement reaction. In Frye's rearrangement reaction, the phenolic ester, this is phenolic ester, will rearrange itself in such a way that it transforms into hydroxyaryl ketone. This is hydroxyaryl ketone, and this will happen in the presence of Lewis acid. Take any Lewis acid like this, aluminium chloride. So Frye's rearrangement reaction, in the reaction in which this is phenolic ester rearrange itself in such a way that it gives hydroxyaryl ketone in presence of Lewis acid. Now we will see the mechanism of this reaction. The first step of the mechanism of the reaction is attack of Lewis acid. So we will draw here phenolic ester. This is phenolic ester and this is Lewis acid. Now first step of this reaction mechanism is that attack of Lewis acid on the phenolic ester. Now you see this Lewis acid has two electron donor groups. Oxygen of this phenolic oxygen and carboxylic oxygen. But you see that the lone pair of the phenolic oxygen are in conjugation with this aryl ring. So these are not available for the attack on the aluminium trichloride. But you see this is a carboxylic oxygen and the lone pair on the oxygen are most available for the attack. So what will happen in this step? This oxygen will donate electron to the aluminium trichloride and the product will form like this. This will be the phenolic ester O C double bond O CH3. This oxygen will donate electron to the aluminium trichloride. So it will get positive charge. So aluminium will get negative charge and this is CH3. So this is the first step in which complex is formed. The second step of this reaction is that the formation of acylium carbocation. So now you see that these electrons on this oxygen atom are in conjugation with this aryl ring. So this will acquire positive charge and this bond is single bond and weak bond compared to this double bond. So this bond gets polarized and what will happen, this oxygen will pull electrons from the carbon atom like this. This oxygen also pull electrons from the aluminium complex and this oxygen will donate electron to the aluminium. So in this step, the step of acylium carbocation formation, this cation will form and the step will be like this. This is phenolic ester this is oxygen, and with this oxygen this aluminum will bond. And phenolic ester will form, and this will be our carbocation. No, not here. Yes. So in this second step, carbocation is formed. Now this third step of this reaction is the electrophilic substitution reaction. So we will go to next step. So this step we can write into two steps. So what will happen here? An oxygen have lone pair of electron. This is aluminum trichloride. The oxygen will donate electron to the ring. So this will be like this. So this bond will get double bond. This bond will be double bond positive, and this aluminum trichloride. Okay, and this will get negative charge. This will get negative charge plus this carbocation. This is the first case. The second case will be this electron will be transferred here, and this electron will go at the para position. So this reaction will be like this, this state. So para position will acquire negative charge. This will be like this. And negative CO3 plus carbocation. So we have to drop it. So the electrophilic substitution step have two options. This electrophile can take up electrons from this orthocation, ortho carbon, or this electrophile take up electrons from the para carbon. These two criteria, these two conditions are depends upon three factors. Factor one, the kinetic energy of this carbocation. Second factor is that this steric hindrance of this oxygen aluminum complex, and third is availability of the electron at the carbon atom, whether it is at ortho position or para position. So two cases can be observed at a different temperature. Suppose at high temperature, in this case high temperature is high. What will happen in high temperature? The kinetic energy of this carbocation will be so much high, so it can overcome the steric hindrance of this aluminum oxygen complex easily. And as soon as electrons are available at the ortho position of the ring, this carbocation will take up electron from this ortho position, and it will not allow electrons to go at para position. So in this case, this electrophile carbocation will attack at ortho position, and this step will be look like this. At this position this will attack. This will be double bond negative zero. This step will be only at high temperature. Now at low temperature, this case at low temperature. At low temperature, the kinetic energy of this carbocation will not be so high. So it will not overcome the steric hindrance of this aluminum oxygen complex even though electrons are available at ortho position, it will not take up because it cannot overcome the hindrance of this aluminum oxygen complex. So at this position, this electron, it will allow to go at the para position, and when it will go at the para position, there will be no steric hindrance and it will attack at the para position. So in this step, this will form, para isomer will form. This will be like this. So at this third step, in electrolytic substitution, two isomer will form. One is para isomer and one is ortho isomer. Next step is elimination of the hydrogen atom. So there is a hydrogen atom, there is also a hydrogen atom. So hydrogen, this bond will move here and this bond will move here. In this case also, what will happen? This bond will move here, this bond will move here, this bond will move here. So it will form like this. So this will be like this here. You can see here this high temperature, this will be like this. This C double bond O CH3, and this will be single bond, and this is AlCl3. This will be at high temperature, and at low temperature, this will form. Para isomer will form. Oh, this AlCl3 negative plus H positive, because H positive will be eliminated from here. Next step is that attack of H positive ion. Fourth step is attack of H positive ion. So what will happen? This electrons will move here and this electrons will attack H positive ion. In this case also, this electrons will move here and here will be lone pair attack, it will attack H positive ion. So what will happen? What will form? We will see here. It will form our ortho isomer. This will be OH and C double bond O CH3 plus catalyst will be regenerated, that is AlCl3. In this ortho isomer also, same thing will happen. This will be like this OH, because this H will move here. And this C double bond O CH3 plus catalyst will regenerate AlCl3. So in this way, at high temperature ortho isomer will form, and at low temperature para isomer will form. So depending on the temperature, this isomer will be formed. Hope you have understood these lectures and its temperature dependency of this para and ortho isomer. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my CV Raman chemistry classes. Thank you.